It's easy to put on some headphones or put some earbuds in our ears and just listen to music or enjoy podcasts or audiobooks. But what if you couldn't actually enjoy any of that stuff? Moreover, what if you actually didn't have the ability to hear the world around you? In a similar way, we take tech for granted. There's so much of it in our daily lives that we just assume tech is going to benefit us in some sort of way. That's why this video is so special to me. I sat down for a conversation with a man named Skyler, a gentleman whose life has literally been made better by innovations in hearing technology. And by merging the two things that we take for granted together, he has been given the gift of hearing and so much more. Skyler is a recipient of a cochlear implant, which uses what is called the Nucleus 7 sound processor. This man now has an implant in his head that connects to his smartphone, both Android and Apple smartphones, and allows him to actually enjoy media, and also the mics on it allow him to hear the world around him. I had to ask him, does he actually feel like a cyborg now?
So I've got my bionic ears, custom parts. I have like a Beethoven shirt where it's him with a horn. So I like to kind of make light of me going deaf with everything. So I do say sometimes, hey, I'm bionic, or it helps people understand a little bit better. About 6-7 years ago, I actually went deaf in my right ear. Couple years ago, well, now I guess it's 2.5 years roughly. It's a funny thing, because I proposed to my fiance, like, and that was awesome. So it was like high point of my life. We went on vacation. And then about 2 weeks later, my ear on my left side started getting muffled. I was more okay losing her voice. I was more okay losing my parents' voice. The minute I lost my voice was where I like became super depressed and devastated. My family's big on, sorry. I didn't think it was gonna be this emotional, I'm sorry. My family's big on like talking. Culturally, we always ate around a table. We'd always talk for hours. And that's our big thing, is we just talk and catch up and do all that. It was hard going to even see them and be around them when they're all talking, because I couldn't really...
Oh,
you're good. I love talking about it, because I don't get to share it that much. And
we're happy to give you this.
I love sharing it and talking about it, because it really is like a... I'm like, I could be a Lifetime movie. Luckily, like, I was able to find a great audiologist that's in San Dimas, who he knew what was kind of happening. He's like, hey, like, it looks like it's genetic. You're going deaf. It looks like you'll never get it back again, but you're a great candidate for cochlears.
Now let me give you some info about Cochlear in general. They are a leader in implantable hearing solutions, and the benefits of their work are tangible thanks to people like Skyler sharing their stories. He's one of 50 million Americans who experience hearing loss, either from birth or gradually throughout their lives. For people with profound to severe hearing loss, Cochlear is a true gift. Now, one thing to remember is that there is the implant inside of his head that does all of the sound processing, but then the mics and the batteries that power it all are what connect to it via magnets. When he took off the actual earpiece, I kind of freaked out a little, because I thought that was the implant at first, and I thought that that was a permanent part of his head.
It's a little gross, but they kind of drill into your head and they make a little hole, and then it kind of follows like the layout of this. So they do a hole, and then they have like a wire.
I thought that it was like permanently there.
No, it comes off. So there's a processor in my head that they went ahead and placed with a magnet, and that's how everything connects. And there's like a little cord essentially that connects directly to the nerve. So it bypasses everything and then just goes straight there. So one of the fun jokes, I can go like this and I can still hear everyone, or like, I do that occasionally. Gets turned on, and which is an oddity, not a lot of people tend to do it. I actually was able to hear voices like the minute they turned on. Leaving the office, my dad was like, hey, just go ahead and call your mom. And I'm like, I'm not gonna be able to hear her or anything like that. And he's like, just call her, just to see, just to test. It goes straight to voicemail and I hear her voice, and that's where I just start like bawling. Because I hear my mom, sorry, it's getting to me now. So I heard my mom for the first time in like a year, which was funny because I'm laughing and I'm like, of course this is her. She never answers her phone. And so of course the first time I hear her is gonna be her voicemail. Yeah. And this lady on the elevator is just like staring at us. Yeah. And I'm just like, I'm sorry. Like, I just heard my mom's for the voice for the first time in a year. I went deaf and now I can hear again. And she's just sitting there and she's like, oh, this is so great. She's like, oh, so you're hearing my voice for the first time too. I mean, it's the first time we've ever talked, so it's the first time too. But you hear my voice too. She's like, I feel so honored and special.
By connecting it to an iPhone in this case, but it also connects to Android phones, you can customize your hearing experience. I mean, we have certain products like little truly wireless earbuds like this that give us a little bit of control over how the media comes into our ears. But in his case, he's literally EQing the entire world around him. It's like he has superhuman hearing.
There's a bunch of settings that they can set that are pre-programmed for everything. They gave the forward focus. This was a new thing that I actually pushed forward to get unlocked. It's kind of only with like the N7s, it's with the newer ones, where it attunes just to human voices mainly. So it funnels it in the front and it completely cuts off in the back. You can connect to your different devices. So I have a TV streamer that I can click the button and it clicks over to the TV streamer. I have the mini mic where it'll click over to that. If I want, I can like adjust, depending on what I have connected to, this is where I would adjust the volume. The hard thing is like, I go to the gym a lot now. Yeah. Like once I went deaf, I needed
an outlet.
Yeah, an outlet of some sort. And so I started working out, cause I was like, man, I got fat. I'm like, I need to get in shape. So I started going to the gym and doing everything. If I'm listening to music, like with my fiance when we work out, fine, nobody comes up to us, no one says anything, like anything about it, like they just think we're normally working out. If I'm by myself, people try to talk to me when I'm listening to music, and I'm like, they're like, are you done with the machine? I'm just sitting there working out, and I'm like, I look over, I'm like, sorry, I didn't hear you, I'm listening to music, and they're like, no, you're not, you don't have headphones, and I'm like, 10 years ago, I'd have a big battery pack here, and like everything like that, and a bunch of tubes, stuff like that, whereas now, I have something small, and like, even this, the N7 is smaller from the N6. It really was a great thing. Like, I can't speak for everyone. Going from being in the hearing world to being deaf was such a hard thing for me. The only way I could communicate was reading people's lips, or I used a talk-to-text app just to try to do that. And I've learned that those are terrible. The technology is not up to where it should be, where it's at. And there's kind of a stigma towards people who are deaf, and it makes you less social and everything like that. Luckily, this has allowed me to become social again. Like, I still have problems because it's a self-conscious thing, but it's allowed me to go out and be more social with everybody. And now I want to do my best to try to get back. I want to kind of be an advocate and be like, hey, here are problems with the system. We need to kind of push and fix it. That's part of the reason I really wanted to do this, because like I can voice my opinions and say, hey, look, here's problems, here's the great things with this, and I wanted to show the different technology. So I absolutely love it being back. There are flaws, but I do love being able to hear again.
And I think that's a really good note to end this on, not only in the way that Cochlear really benefited Skyler's life, but how much Skyler wants to give back to the community and the community of people that he is now a part of because of this experience that he's gone through. And I hope after watching this video, you no longer take these things for granted. Not only the tech that we have in our hands or in our lives, but also our sense of hearing and just how important that is for all of us. A shout out to Skyler. He is honestly one of the coolest guys that I have ever met. We're actually friends now, and we're gonna be hanging out quite a bit because we're fairly local in this area. So a shout out to Skyler. Thank you so much for not only doing this interview, but also for being just a wonderful soul. Cochlear as well, a quick shout out to them. Their info is found in links in the description down below. If you want to learn more about this hearing technology, this revolutionary technology, then you can learn more about the Cochlear implant and the Nucleus 7 sound processor in the links in the description below. And on the note of not taking too many things for granted, let's just take a moment one last time to thank Skyler and Cochlear, and I will call it on this video, and I will just remind you to enjoy your tea, everybody.